after an unsuccessful play day, as Jasmine wasn't feeling very well, we've now gone to McDonald's in case you were thinking we're always super healthy. Now I've got a child-free day as I'm working. I've got my glasses on, we're having a day of Evoke. Evoke Media Group, our company, filming and giving media advice. Now we're off to the Hepworth Gallery to do some crafts, I think, and to meet our church friends. I'm off to the gym and the bank, woo woo! And now I'm child free. I'm on a girls' night out, a single mum night out tonight. I'm ready and I'm dressed and I'm off to Wakefield Pride! Really wanted to give the honest side of single life and single parenting life. When you ain't got kids, it's kind of like, got loads to get out of bed for in the morning, got loads of cool work on that I love, but I am struggling with being separated from them for quite a long time. I'm just sorting out the house and getting some last minute work written, because then the kids are coming back, so I'm looking forward to seeing them. And I'm sure the house will get trashed within a matter of seconds. We're in the car with Popo, Jazz and Ari, and we're off to BBC Country File Live. So we're at Nostell Estate and we're here for a movie, pizza and gin night for Wakefield bondholders. I've got the kids now. This morning I had to do some work and go to an appointment, so the kids stopped, sorry you can see my bra, the kids stopped at Popo's last night, as I had my work due, which was an outdoor movie and pizza and gin night, although I didn't have any gin. So gym done, and now it's National Play Day this Wednesday, so at the Hepworth. First things first, we're eating Nutella hams. And a pick pebble and paint. So the kids have got loads to play with that you couldn't ask for more, but they're not playing. I think they're just covering with tape these sculptures, and then they're gonna make it one big sculpture. This is the new garden at the Hepworth Wakefield. We've been watching it being built, haven't we? I don't think they've finished it yet. Right, so we'll go play in the playground as that's what you want to do. I guess it is National Play Day, so you can do what you want in terms of play.
Do you want to do the same as what's there? What they're doing? Okay, we'll
number one.
After an unsuccessful play day, as Jasmine wasn't feeling very well, we've now gone to McDonald's in case you were thinking we're always super healthy.
Mama, I'm not. I have a cough.
You have a cough. Oh, look at that awful cough.
You're trying to cough.
And now we're on our way to Popo's and Grandad Lee's, aren't we?
No, we're not.
Yeah, we are.
No, we're not. We're sleeping at ours.
Got a blob, the orange blob says it's recording you and you can vlog. Hey guys, I'm Ariana. I'm currently eating an Oreo McFlurry on my way to Sheffield to go to my grandma's house.
She's not a grandma.
What is she then?
Popo.
Popo. Chinese for grandma.
A mouse one.
Good morning everyone. So we had a play day fail as you saw yesterday. Oh sugar, I've just realised I didn't do up my zip at the back. Now I'm having a mum fail. Because Jasmine wasn't very well, so she was really mardy during play day at the Hepworth. So we didn't manage to go to the new opening of a new playground experience at Meadowhall. We just went home instead and then went to my mum's. And we also did a McDonald's stop for the poorly kids. And then now I've got a child-free day as I'm working. I've got my glasses on, we're having a day of Evoke. Evoke Media Group, our company, filming and giving media advice. And I have been doing a little spin in my new dress too. So today's been a good day. I've been working a lot, so lots of sitting down. So I did go to the gym and did body combat, which I haven't done for ages, but it's good to mix up your exercise routine, even though my belly dancer hips hurt now because I was doing lots of kicks and punches and stuff. But like, I like my hips are overly flexible because I'm hyper flexible. So when I'm doing like high kicks, I can high kick, but it means like my hips going all over the joint as well. But anyhow, the kids are back now, so getting them to bed and then hopefully a day, well, we're out tomorrow again, meeting some friends from church, and then I'll do some crazy dancing with them to finish off the week nicely, because then on Saturday night, I am out with my friend Claire, as I have a child-free weekend ahead. And you can also see a rainbow flag in the background because I'm off to Wakefield Pride on Sunday, probably hanging from Saturday night. But that's all good. Good morning, everyone. We've had a massive lie-in, but now we're off to the Hepworth Gallery to do some crafts, I think, and to meet our church friends. So I actually thought I'd feel a lot better, more energised after a big lie-in. I actually feel really sleepy. So let's go, pink ladies. We're gonna grease lightning. Go grease lightning. Do do do. Go grease lightning.
There's one pink doll.
One pink doll. Right, we best run, girls. We're late now. My fault. Okay, y'all follow the leaders. Show me where we're going for crafts. This will be me on Sunday after a night out. There is, but I don't know where.
Today, inspired by the sculptures in galleries, in Gallery 1.
Wow. This is Ari's greatest showman dance. You got sass. Woo! Right, we best get you to Dada, and I'm off
but
to gym.
Take them?
He's gonna come pick up your stuff tomorrow.
Today.
Okay, I'll ask him. Right, let's go. Hi. I'm off to the gym and the bank. Woo woo! And now I'm child free. Hey everyone, so I've just jumped out the shower, as you can see, and I'm very excited because I'm on a girls' night out, a single mum night out tonight, although I decided what underwear I'm wearing, but I haven't decided what clothes, and I'm really late now because I've been hoovering the house and trying to clear up the carnage that the children have left, because they're coming around here for pre-drinks and snacks first. So help, I best get my hair done, face on. And hopefully they don't arrive whilst I'm still in my underwear. But hey ho, I'm sure they won't judge. So I'm finally ready and we're off out. So you can check our live vlog from our night out that we've just done on my YouTube channel. Claire is ready. Becca is ready. Sophie is ready. So
bye.
See you later. Good morning, everyone. I wasn't looking as bright as this when I first rolled out of bed and somehow made it to kettlebells. I didn't get a chance to vlog, but now I'm ready and I'm dressed and I'm off to Wakefield Pride to meet my dads and my friend who you might have seen last night, Becca. She's coming to her first Pride too. So let's do this. Hopefully some more dancing, as I did a lot of dancing last night. I was dripping in sweat. Don't get me wrong. Say hello! Hair shush time! Got our leaves! Looking good!
If you buy things on Apple, they're expensive and they don't go wrong.
Shout out my friend Pippa! My dancing partner is standing up!
It's a photo. Who's got a rainbow flag?
Look, Wakefield is wonderful. I really wanted to give the honest side of single life and single parenting life. I guess it's for me, it's very much on the shared childcare thing. As I know, each single parenting journey is different and there's pros and cons to each. It's often hard at the start to see the pros, but there definitely are some. And like, I've had a super busy weekend last week. We're keeping busy with work and Pride and going out and stuff. And then today, maybe because it's Monday, it just feels really quiet. you've got nobody to look after. And don't get me wrong, oh, there's my phone. I'm super busy with work and all that. And I've got loads on, and I've been to the gym, which has made me feel lots better. And whilst it was lovely to bump into my daughters near the gym, it really hit me, like, because I spent like 7 years looking after them full time, and then like to see him in the street, sorry, that's my Twitter going off because I've been tweeting about it. To see him in, I look like I'm on Blair Witch Project, sorry, it's my lamp. And I think it was just to see them like in a normal situation, to bump into your own kids when they're still little. It's really hard, because whilst it's so nice to see how happy they are, and I'm so grateful that they've got two sets of loving families, it's really difficult when it's like you feel like you're an outsider for a lot of their life, and you don't know what's going on with them and stuff. And don't get me wrong, like, I've always been a big believer that children should see both parents and equally so, unless there's other reasons that they're not safe or in a loving home, then obviously that's different. But so I am very much for this. It's just really hard. And it just does break your heart a little bit. And it's really weird because it feels like almost like a grief. It's ridiculous. I'm being pathetic. Like, I'm so lucky. My kids are still here. They're still happy. I'm only just seeing them half the time. And then, but I think they're just still so young. So I'm just finding it difficult. Like, I keep really busy and I've got a lot going on, so actually this is good that I've got my time, and I'm planning to start doing things that I've not done for a while, like teaching dance again because I've got time to do that, and going to football, joining my football team again. This is time for me, and I've been trying to be really positive about it, and I don't know why. Just today, seeing them, maybe it's also because I had such a fun-filled weekend, busy and stuff with my friends, so I didn't feel lonely. And then it's like the normal week comes, everyone else is back to their families and that, and you just, you know, you can just focus on your work. But I've realised in my old age of 31, that life isn't just about work, is it? And I just feel really distant from my own kids. And I just really struggle with that. Maybe I just need to just focus myself on work and sleep. I think my biggest saviour has been focusing on friendships and the gym, keeping fit, because that really does make me feel good. And it distracts me, and it's something positive for me, and it helps my mental health, my well-being, everything it helps. I think it's just thrown me a bit. When you see them, your own kids.
and what you, like, you're missing out on half their life. Maybe I'm just having an emotional day. But if you felt like this, do comment and let me know so I don't feel quite so ridiculous. I'm probably just having a really emotional day. I probably listened to the wrong playlist on my Apple Music and that. Because I was trying to listen to like a chilled out emotional playlist. So I probably listened to the wrong one. So that hadn't helped either. Right, anyway. I'm going to work in bed because it is late. Hey everyone, I was going to say good morning, but it's about 3 p.m. I did actually get up very early this morning. I kind of rolled out of bed. I was feeling really anxious. And I don't know if it's because I had 3 gins on Saturday night and I'm not used to alcohol. But you can see my funny live vlog anyway if you want to. But I just feel like, I don't know, when you ain't got kids, it's kind of like... Got loads to get out of bed for in the morning. Got loads of cool work on that I love. But I am struggling with being separated from them for quite a long time. But I did. I rolled my scent out of bed and got to the gym and did, what did I do? Boxer size. Somehow I just kind of tend to wake up and think, oh my days, I'm doing some like squat jump thing in my dream, and I'm actually at the gym probably looking absolutely rough and annoying everyone because I'm going really slow because I'm still asleep. But anyhow, got myself ready and I've done loads of work at home, and now I'm off out to do some errands, and I'm off to a director's board meeting as I'm a director for a local business. But yeah, so I'm doing that now, and then I'm off Dirty Dancing. So, do you know, a very, random mix of a day, but very productive at least, and I am feeling a lot better now. Just deep breaths, because my anxiety is quite high. But yeah, I'll feel better when I'm at the board meeting anyway, because I do like working with people, because it can get lonely on your own, especially when you're running businesses. Yeah, it's a weird place to be. It's great, but it can be lonely. But yeah, I've got my send dress scrubbed up and I'm off out. So I'll see you all later. I'm probably not going to be back till after my Dirty Dancing, so I might take you to my Dirty Dancing. So let's go. So I've only just made it home now. I've been go Grease Lightning. Ding, 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 ding. Not like that anyway, but you know. I've been doing my Dirty Dancing and Grease rehearsal after my board meeting, and they didn't think I were for the board meeting, the security guards, they nearly didn't let me in, it's probably because of how I dress, but never mind. I've been moving my hips at dance, so I feel a lot better after a bit of dancing, and now back to a quiet house, and it's my last night of quietness, and then tomorrow I've got the kids, yay! So I've got to get up early first for HIIT, sort out the house, and then it's kiddie time. So I'm looking forward to seeing them, because I have really missed them, and I've been keeping super duper busy, really productive day, so that is good. But yeah, it does feel quiet. Although I've got used to the quiet and the tidiness, relatively tidiness anyway. So it is weird because then you have to suddenly adjust again for half a week of mayhem and chaos and then adjust back to quietness and tidiness and keeping on top of things. So yeah, it's a funny shift, but I'm going to have my tea. It's a bit late. So tea in bed with a cuppa, and finishing off some more work / watching Netflix. So night-night. God bless. Ciao. Good morning everyone. So I managed again to roll out of bed and got myself to HIIT class. I'm really struggling with getting up in the morning, but somehow after about 20,000 snoozes and resetting my alarm, I managed to get ready in about 5 minutes and just turn up at the gym, because any exercise is better than nothing. And now I do feel a bit better. I'm still really tired, but I'm just sorting out the house and getting some last minute work written, because then the kids are coming back. So I'm looking forward to seeing them. And I'm sure the house will get trashed within a matter of seconds. So I'm trying to do my work and a little bit of cleaning before chaos ensues. So first, getting changed. So the kids are home and I think they just want a day in today, which is nice just to get them back settled. Now as we're coming to moving house, I'm going to be sorting out the garage. I have just started and I spoke to my good friend LaToya. She says I don't need a man to make it happen. So true. It just feels a bit lonely when you're sorting out garage and that. And moving all these like huge shelves. So I either need some really strong friends or I do need a man. No, I do need just some strong friends to help me lift all these shelves and move house. But for today, I'm doing it on my own. Good morning, everyone. So today we're in the car with Popo, Jazz and Ari, and we're off to BBC Country File Live. I've never actually watched the BBC TV show, but I believe there's lots of outdoor activities today, a vintage fairground, lots of food and drink stalls. So I'm ready as if we're going to a festival. But yeah, it should be a fun day out, and we're writing a review for my blog yorkshirefamilies.co.uk, so you can check the full review there.
So after lots of holiday traffic on the A64, we're nearly there. We can see signs for Country File Live at Castle Howard. I've never actually been to Castle Howard before in York, so it'll be interesting to see.
It's like gold.
It's got brown on top.
I don't know what it is. After lots of traffic, we're making our way. Is it a crown on top? Yeah, you're right, Ari. Oh, that's nice. Do you reckon they'd notice if I'd put in my handbag to take for our garden? There's a wheel. Jasmine wants to go on it, but Ariana doesn't. We made it. So they weren't lying when they recommended setting off super early, as there was long traffic queues. But hey, we're here and we're finally outside and the weather is nice, so let's head in. So the motley crew today is, we've got me, Sophie, aka Mama May, Bad Mom, and we've got my mama, aka Popo, Jasmine, my daughter, we've got my stepdad Lee, and my stepbrother Oscar and his girlfriend Ashley, and Rabbit. Say hi, Osh. Say hi, Osh.
It looks like Jasmine's having a baby. A baby rabbit.
Who's watched Country File?
One.
Osk.
Country File?
Yeah.
I don't think I've got to walk
with Harry. Mum, Lee, you watch Country File?
I love Country File.
Yeah, do you love
Country File? Do you?
It's become one of the best programs of the week.
It's like a really good magazine almost, yes.
And it really takes you to places you've never expected, or even in your own areas, you know. It's
wonderful. Yeah, but what really happens with the farming practices.
So you can tell the demographic anyway. But it's opening it up to a new audience. Get your press wristbands on, Ari.
Tighter.
Okay. So we checked in, now let's go in. First things first, photo opportunity. Come on, get up on the haystack. Yeah. Tractor. Should we have a look, Harry? Ah, oh, look at those cuties. Wow. How cute are they? You're right, Osk. How are you two feeling? Because this was a surprise day out for you two. Are you okay with all the crowds?
Yeah, not too bad, thanks.
That's good. Girls, apparently you can go kayaking in the lake. So there's a dog show, stage, climbing wall. There. Where the Ferris wheel is.
The way I feel.
Dodging time. dogs. Right, shall we go across?
For me.
And then we're going to get everybody to have a go joining in.
See you later, Country File.
So we've left the kids and my mama to enjoy the rest of Country File Live, as there's lots of fairground rides. We finished off with a bit of a maypole dance in front of the croquet course, and there was an opera singer. Just like my childhood, Hayley.
Yeah, just like
exactly like it. But yeah, we've had a lovely day out, and now for more fun and child-free fun, although I know kids can come, but I can't say because it's a surprise for Oscar and Ashley. So come on, let's go. I nearly did say then. Yes. So I'm having a quick change in the car, and Ashley and Oscar still don't know where we're going. What do you think we're doing, guys?
No, dead bum.
You got a dead bum.
Yeah, it's
not very comfortable. It's a higher car, and it's hard to get changed in such a confined environment as well. We're nearly there.
Oh, thank goodness for that. Can't wait to stand up.
Yeah. We're all numbing bum. So we're at Nostell Estate and we're here for a movie, pizza and gin night for Wakefield bondholders. So do you know what we're doing, guys? We're watching Avengers outdoors with pizza and gin. And you like Avengers, don't you?
Yeah.
So it's a group I'm part of called Wakefield Bondholders. Yeah. So that's what's on now.
Now I want to revenge.
Hey everyone, so it's Friday. I've got the kids now. This morning I had to do some work and go to an appointment. So the kids stopped, sorry, you can see my bra. The kids stopped at Popo's last night, as I had my work due, which was an outdoor movie and pizza and gin night. Although I didn't have any gin because I only had a few gins last Saturday and it took me probably until Wednesday to recover. So I am avoiding alcohol because I can't take it well until I plan a proper night. So yeah, but the pizza was really good and I had a vegan pizza. But yeah, done some work this morning, got on train, done some more work, doing a little bit more work, meeting my business partner now. It's raining. But then I think I'm going to take Jasmine climbing. What's really nice, we are starting to settle into this kind of shared parenting routine. The girls are a lot less fractious and they're a lot more settled, which is nice. And I feel a lot less pressured, you know, to kind of perform when they're here. So we're settling back down now. But will be really nice because I'm taking Jazz on her own climbing because she absolutely loves climbing. Whereas Ari, kind of, she'll do it for a little bit, but her attention span's not that long. Whereas Jazz is very particular, so she likes kind of judging all the different, what do you call them? Climbing walls. I was going to call them pedals. They're not pedals. What are they? Oh my days. Believe it or not, I did a climbing course for my birthday. I cannot remember. Whatever. Those things, the hook things on wall. So yeah, I'm going to take Jazz for that. And so hopefully it's kind of bursts of quality time together. And we'll see how I feel when they leave again on Monday. But that's all for me this week. Thanks for watching. And I will be doing more lives because when the kids aren't here, it's really, really nice to talk to you. Not that it's not nice when they're here, but it's a lot harder when they're here to talk or think about anything else other than what's happening right in that situation. But anyway, lots of love, peace and shimmies.